गुड आफ्टरनून गाइज, एस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द पिस्टन. ओके, वी हैव सीन द पिस्टन बैरल, पिस्टन रिंग, देन टाइप्स ऑफ द पिस्टन रिंग. देर इज ए कॉम्प्रेशन रिंग, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए प्रेशर रिंग. और सेकेंड पार्ट वी हैव सीन द ऑयल कंट्रोल रिंग, और इट इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए ऑयल स्क्रैपर रिंग. ओके, अगेन वी हैव सीन द वॉट टाइप ऑफ द मटेरियल इज यूज फॉर मेड द पिस्टन रिंग. ओके, देन वी हैव सीन द सम फॉर्मुलेज, वी हैव कैलकुलेट द रेडियल थिकनेस ऑफ द पिस्टन रिंग. ओके, then we have seen the gap between the three rings. then after that we have seen the next part, piston skirt. okay, in that we have calculated the rn value. okay, then today we'll going on the next part. this is the important part of the IC engine, the connecting rod of the IC engine component. okay, in the what is the function of the connecting rod? You know that there are some functions, primary functions, secondary functions are given for the connecting rod. See in the figure, the primary function of the connecting rod is to transmit the attractive force from the piston to the crank pin, or we can say the vice versa. Okay, in some cases its secondary function is to carry the lubricant oil from the crank pin to the piston pin. There is a one hole is drilled, through that hole we can do the lubrication of the crank pin to the piston pin. Okay, this is the secondary function of the connecting rod. There are some parameters discussed with the reference to the design of the connecting rod. We'll see the parameters of the connecting rod one by one. First is a construction of the connecting rod. See in the figure, the construction of the connecting rod is given. Then which type of the material is used to making the connecting rod. This is the second parameter, material for the connecting rod. Third is a load acting on the connecting rod. There are different load acting on the connecting rod. We'll find out that load acting on the connecting rod. Okay, fourth is a connecting rod. We want the design. Okay, means design of the connecting rod body. This is the fourth parameter, connecting rod design. Okay, and fifth is a last parameter, design of other parts of the connecting rod. Other parts means small parts. There is a bolt is there. Okay, rod nut is there, rod bushing is there, bearing are there. Okay, etc. Or there are two ends are given for the connecting rod, small end and big end. Okay, and the connecting of that small end and big end, we are using the shank. Okay, this is the coming under the design of the other parameters of the connecting rod. See in the figure, there are shown the small end of the bearing. Okay, and it is also called as the small end is also called as outer portion of the small end, I end. And this big end and small end are connected with the help of shank, or it is also called as a body of the connecting rod. Okay, the big end, or we can say the big end bearing or big end bearing cap. There are three parts are connected to the shank or body of the connecting rod. Okay, that figure from the connecting rod used in the IC engine. The body of the connecting rod again consists of, I have told already, there are three parts. Which three parts? First is a small end, or it is also called as a I end, and second is a big end, okay, and third is a shank or body, okay. Then we will see details one by one, okay. First is a small end. Small end of the connecting rod is completely integral with the body of the connecting rod, and the carries the piston pin bearing. Okay, what they are carries? Piston pin bearing. The connecting rod is connected to the piston through the small end. Check in the figure. The connecting rod is connected to the piston through the small end with the help of piston pin or gudgeon pin. Yesterday we have designed the piston pin. It is also called as a gudgeon pin. Okay. And what about the big end? The big end of the connecting rod is usually split, shown in figure, to take the crank pin bearing shell. Okay. And the connecting rod is connected to the crank through the big end. With the help of what? Crank pin. With the help of what? Crank pin. They are connected, the big end. And third part is a shank, or it is also called as a body of the connecting rod. Shank or body of the connecting rod consists of two parts, big end and small end, both we have seen. It is a taper shape. If you have seen, the shape of that shank is a taper from the small end to the big end. It is continuously subjected to the alternative compressive and tensile forces. There are two forces are induced in the shank or body. This forces is compressive and tensile forces. They are induced alternatively. Okay, the shape of the cross section of the connecting rod are maybe rectangular, circular, elliptical, tubular, I section and H section, depend on the strength or size of the connecting rod. Okay, this shape will select. See, for example, in the low speed engine, the section is usually circular with flattened side, or we can say the elliptical or rectangular. If the low speed engine is there, then we are use circular, then elliptical or rectangular section of the connecting rod. The large dimension of the cross section is in the plane of rotation. Okay, but in high speed engine, the weight reduction is the major objective. That's why we are using I section or H section are used in the high speed engine. I section and H section, why? Because of they have higher section modulus per unit area as compared to the circular, elliptical or rectangular section. If they have high modulus per unit area, okay, then we are using this is in high speed engine. Then they offers better resistance against the bending as well as a buckling. That's why we are using I or H section in the connecting rod. Okay, then what about the length of the connecting rod? Okay, length of the connecting rod is depends on the ratio of the connecting rod length to the crankshaft radius ratio. Okay, crankshaft radius. Okay, we can say the length of the connecting rod is depends on the L by R ratio. Okay, if the L by R ratio is shorter or small of the connecting rod, which reduce the overall height of the engine. Okay, if the ratio L by R is small or shorter, then the engine size also small. It makes the engine compact. Okay, however, shorter the length of the connecting rod with respect to the crank, okay, crank, greater is angularity, which increase the side thrust, okay, of the piston on the cylinder liner. In addition, because of greater angularity of the connecting rod, the length of the piston skirt has to be short, so as to avoid the contact between the piston skirt and the body of the connecting rod. We want to avoid the distance or contact between the piston skirt and the body of the connecting rod with the help of what? Greater angularity. If the L by ratio is large, okay, or longer in the connecting rod, which reduce the angularity of the connecting rod, okay. If you are getting the lesser angularity, leads to the reduction in the side of the thrust of the piston on the cylinder liner, okay, remember that. Then all of you getting that, okay. In addition, there are lesser angularity allows use the piston, okay, use the piston. Lesser angularity is allow the use the piston with long the skirt's length, okay. Long connecting rod increase the overall height of the engine. There are some common values for the L by ratio are 4:5, okay. With high speed engine using L by ratio less than 4, while low speed engine using L by ratio is greater than 5. Remember that two value, L by ratio is 4:5. For high speed engine using L by ratio is less than 4, and low speed engine we are using the greater than 5. Okay, second is the which material is used for the connecting rod. A connecting rod is one of the most heavily stressed part of an IC engine. It is subjected to fluctuating stresses. Okay, fluctuating stresses. Most of the connecting rod are manufactured by the forging. The material used for the connecting rod should be have high putty strength and resilience. The material used for the connecting rod range from the medium carbon steel to the alloy steel. Okay, the material of the connecting rod is from the medium carbon steel to the alloy steel. The medium carbon steel, for example, 40C8 or 45C8, having the ultimate tensile strength of near about 600 to 700 Newton per mm square. That's why we are choose the material medium carbon steel are used for the low speed and light duty engine. Okay, where is the application of that low speed and high light duty engine? Okay, then the alloy steel is for example 40 CRL, okay, 40 Ni3, having the ultimate tensile strength, okay, more than the this 700 to 1500 Newton per mm square or MPa. These are used in the high speed and a heavy duty engines. Okay, there are two materials are given for the low duty engine and heavy duty engine. Okay, you have to choose that material as per the ultimate tensile strength. Okay, because heavy duty engine we require the maximum tensile strength. This tensile strength is in between 700 to 1500 MPa, and low duty engine this strength is a 600 to 700 MPa. Remember that. Then there are a different types of the load acting on the connecting rod. Then which load is acting on the connecting rod? In order to design the connecting rod, it is necessary to analyze the different load acting on the connecting rod. Okay, which load acting on the connecting rod? The loads acting on the connecting rod, first is a force due to the combined effect of the gas pressure. Force due to the combined effect of the gas pressure. Second is a inertia of reciprocating mass. Inertia of the reciprocating mass. And third is a friction at the piston. Friction at the piston. Then there is a, again you will get the bending moment due to the inertia of the connecting rod. Bending moment. Okay. And forces due to the friction at the piston pin and crank pin bearing. In the IC in mechanism, if you have seen, then you will get the different loads acting on the connecting rod. This is the assembly of the connecting rod. You can see there are some parts are given. Connecting rod bolt is given. Second is a connecting rod cap. Third is a connecting rod bearing shell. Fourth is a connecting rod nut. Fifth is a connecting rod body. It is also called as a shank. And last is a connecting rod shing. Okay, this is the assembly of the connecting rod. Okay, if you have seen the different section of the connecting rod, I have already explained plane of the motion. Then you will get the buckling about the XX axis. You have seen details the buckling of column in the SOM subject. Okay, then perpendicular to the plane of motion, buckling about the YY axis. There I have shown in the H section, okay, XX and YY axis. Okay, already I have told there are different types of the load on the connecting rod. There is a 4 times stronger for the buckling about the YY axis as compared to the buckling about the XX axis. Because if you have seen the YY axis, then you will get the more cross sectional area. That's why they are not bent. But if you have seen the XX axis, you will get the less cross sectional area. Okay. We are using the Rankine formula. Rankine critical load required to the buckle the connecting rod. And we are using PCR divided by factor of safety. Okay. C is equal to PCR divided by factor of safety. Then you will get the PCR is equal to PC into factor of safety. Load on CR. See, in that figure, there are two loads. Force on the piston head and force in the connecting rod. Force in the connecting rod. Okay. In that figure, see, L by ratio, L by R ratio, we are considered the pole. Already I have told, this L by ratio is equal to 4. Then, which type of engine we will use? Yes, L by ratio. What is the relation? L by ratio, L by R ratio. Is short. Yes, short. L by ratio are 4 to 5. Okay, this value. We are using for the high speed engine. Then L by R ratio is less than 4. Okay, we have seen that. That's why L by ratio is R is equal to 4. We are using for the high speed engine. High speed engine. P is the force on the piston head. P is equal to how to calculate force? Pi d square divided by 4 into P max. Already we have seen that equation so many times. PC is equal to force in connecting rod. And PS is the side thrust. This force is acting upward direction. Okay. And force on the piston head is acting in the axial direction. See that. And PC is acting tangentially. Okay. Force in connecting rod. Then there we will get the one relation. PC is equal to P divided by cos phi. P divided by cos phi. Okay. And maximum force in the connecting rod. PC is equal to P. When cos phi is equal to 1. And phi is equal to, you will get the 3.3 degree. Then we can write PC is equal to pi d square divided by 4 P max. Pi d square divided by 4 P max. Okay. If you are using the Rankine formula for the buckling in plane motion, already we have seen that equation details in the SOM subject. With the help of that buckling of column, you know the Rankine formula. We have seen one derivation. Here derivation is not given in your book. Okay, you should use the reference as a SOM book, strength of material book. PCR is equal to sigma C into A divided by 1 plus alpha L divided by KXX bracket square. Okay, then if you have calculated that value, B is equal to 4T and H is equal to 5T, I is equal to AK square I. This is given for the radius of gyration K. Okay, sigma C is the compression stress, is the cross sectional area is given. Okay, then you will get the sigma C is equal to 330 MPa and alpha is equal to 1 divided by 7500. Okay, then A is equal to 11 T square, KXX is equal to 1.78 T. H2, this I have make the different section on the connecting rod. See, on the shank or body of the connecting rod, you will get the H2 value is equal to, this range is given, 1.1 H to 1.25 H. If you have seen the H section at the middle of the body of the connecting rod, you will get the H is equal to 5 T, and H1 is the nearest to the small end, H1 is equal to, this range is given, 0.75 H to 0.9 H. Remember that relation. With the help of that relation, you can solve the numericals given on the connecting rod. We'll see the one numerical on that, on the basis of the connecting rod formulas. What we want to find out, determine the dimension of the cross section of the connecting rod. Cylinder bore diameter is given 100 mm. Length of the connecting rod is given 350 mm. Maximum gas pressure is equal to 4 MPa and factor of safety is equal to 6. Okay, then what we want to calculate? Determine the dimension of the cross section of the connecting rod. We want to find out, there are three dimensions in that figure we have seen. Which three dimension? H1 and H2. There are three cross sections we have considered. We want to find out that three dimensions. The force acting on the connecting rod, PC is equal to, we have seen, pi d square divided by 4 into P max. If you are putting the value of bore diameter and P max, then you will get 31415.93 newton. Then you should calculate the buckling load, critical buckling load. How to calculate that critical buckling load? With the help of that again Rankine's formula. PCR is equal to, before going on that, see, PC value is given. PC we have calculated, force acting on the connecting rod into factor of safety. This value we are multiplied by factor of safety because of the safety of the design. You will get 1884.95.58 newton. Then we want to calculate the PCR value. Okay, with the help of Rankine formula. What is the Rankine formula? Sigma C divided into A divided by 1 plus alpha. Alpha is the Rankine constant, divided by L divided by KXX bracket square. Then you should find out the first cross section area. A is equal to 11 T square and radius of gyration value KXX is equal to 1.78 T. Then you will get the sigma C, you have given 330 MPa. Alpha is given, Rankine constant, 1 divided by 7500. Then you will get the T is equal to 7.53. We can write is equal to 8 mm, and B is equal to 4 T. If you are putting the B is equal to 4 T, then you will get the 8 into 4, 32 mm. and you know there are three cross section. H is there, H is equal to 5T, H2 and H1, H2 and H1, okay. Then H is equal to 5T, put the value T is equal to 8, you will get the 40mm. H1 is equal to 0.85, then you will get the H is equal to 34mm. H2 is equal to 1.2H is equal to 48mm. Check that in that equation. Here is a H2, 1.1H2, 1.25. Guy, you should choose the maximum value, okay, because of safety of the design. Safety of the design. Don't choose the less value of the H relation, okay. All of you getting? Then there are a small two ends, okay. Already I have explained, there are two ends, small end and big end. Bearing, this we have seen the assembly of the connecting rod. The small end bearing, see end of the connecting rod, here is a small oil hole is given, okay. This oil hole, with the through the oil hole we are provide the oil to the piston pin, okay, or it is also called as a gudgeon pin. Then piston pin bearing, the thickness is equal to 3 mm, remember that. And design by bearing with the help of some consideration, PC is equal to DP into LP into PB, okay, or LP divided by DP is equal to, this range is given, 1.5 to 2, okay. PB is the allowable bearing pressure, DP is the piston diameter, LP is the piston length. Okay, in that figure I have shown LP is there. If you have taken the cross section of that body, LP length of the piston, DP is the diameter of the piston, okay, and PB is the allowable bearing pressure. Also, you will get the same formula, and the force acting on the connecting rod, PC is equal to pi by 4 D square area into P max, pi by 4 into d square into p max, okay. All of you remember that. Sometimes you will get the questions on the small end, also on the big end bearing. Also similar way, in the big end bearing you have to calculate the force acting on the connecting rod. See, in the big end bearing oil hole is given here, okay, in that figure. See, oil hole is given here. There are two, these are provide this oil hole to the crank pin, okay. This crank pin is attached here. There are two web, and in between that two web there is a crank pin, and the oil hole is given above the crank pin, okay, to provide the oil to the crank pin. If you have taken the cross section of that, then see there is a bearing bush, okay, at the end of the connecting rod, bearing bush is there. Then design, as per the design consideration of the bearing, PC is equal to DC into LC into PB. But what is the ratio of LC to DC? Here is a 1.25 to 1.5. In the small end, check that 1.5 to 2 is there. But here in the big end bearing, you will get that value, 1.25 to 1.5. PB is the allowable bearing pressure. Also force acting, same force is acting, but range is different. You will get the different range for the big end. Then we'll see the one numerical on the basis of small end and big end. Determine the dimension of the small end and big end bearing of the connecting rod. Okay, what is the given data? See, cylinder bore is given 100 mm. Then maximum gas pressure is equal to 4 MPa, and third is a L by D ratio for the piston pin bearing is 2, L by D ratio for the crank pin bearing is 1.3. These two ratio are different for the piston and crank pin, remember that. allowable bearing pressure for the piston pin bearing 12 MPa, or we can say the Newton per mm square, and allowable bearing pressure for the crank pin bearing is 7.5 MPa. Okay, these two value are given in the given data. Then how to calculate the dimension of the small and big end bearing? We'll see. First, we know that we required the force acting on the connecting rod. How to calculate that force acting? We required the area and P max value. Then pi by 4 d square into P max. We'll use that formula and calculate. Then you will get the 314.15.93 Newton. Then dimension of the small end bearing. There are two dimensions, big end bearing and small end bearing. We will see the dimension of the small end bearing. PC is equal to, there is a common formula, DP into LP into PB. Okay, for the bearing is equal to 24 DP square. 24 DP square. If you are putting the value of that, then you will get the DP, LP, PB, 24 DP square. DP is equal to 36.18 or 38 mm. Okay, if you get that value 36.18, or we can say the 38 mm or 37 mm. Okay, LP is equal to, you will get the 76 mm. Then dimension of the big end bearing, PC is equal to DC LC into PB. Again, you will get the 9.75 DC square. Then if you are putting this value, the PC, then you will get the DC is equal to 56.76 or 58 mm. Then LP is equal to 76 mm. Guys, in today's lecture, we have seen the design of the connecting rod. Okay, there is, we have seen the important parts is the connecting rod. Okay, loads on the connecting rod, then also connecting rod assembly, then parts of the connecting rod. Okay, construction of the connecting rod, how to work the connecting rod, all these things we have completed in this lecture. Also, we have seen the how to use the Rankine formula and solve the numericals. Next lecture, I will focus on the numerical. Okay, today we'll stop here. Thank you.
I got that.